Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Sai Gaming Club. I'm Sai, and that's the second episode of the Let's Indie series, where we'll be creating some of the trees. Let's start up by creating a box to mark Area 1, Section 1. We will be adjusting this box with a length of 60, width of 200, and a height of 10. Now let's fix the segment of the box again also to 60, 200, and 10. Now let's fix the material of our area to something more appropriate. I will split it into 4 areas, starting with the green and decaying between dark brown and bright brown. Here you can see the final result. The green area will indicate the area for the player. Light brown for the tall trees, and the ones behind are for the average and short ones. Now let's put a simple box presenting the tall tree to have a better sense of scaling in our area with a height of 40. I think it looks neat, but to also have a better sense of scaling, let's add the camera. Though, see how it will look like in the game. Now let's also add our player. Well, not our main player, but just a box to represent him and see the movement of him. Now our player have the speed of 8, which means he will be moving 8 units per second. Now according to that, there is something wrong with the scaling. The player is too big, so we need to adjust the dimension of our box. Let's bump it to 1 length, 1 width, and 2 height. Now that sounds more normal, except the environment is now more empty. A player shouldn't be that tiny. We can't fix a player according to the physics of Unity, but we can actually adjust the environment. We will cut a piece of the green area where the player is actually interacting with the game. Something like that should work. Let's cap this area. Now let's fix our camera according to the new parameters of our area. Also, let's fix our tree dimensions with 1.25 width, 1.25 length, and remain 40 height. I still think that our camera needs more adjusting. We need to give the player more of the force to see. Now that's better. Now let's repeat our tree multiple times. Here we go. Now there is also, as you remember, an area where the player will be climbing a wall. Now let's do that as well. Now let's create that wall as well. Let me extrude that 10 units. Now let's try our player one more time. You know, to just test the scaling. Now that is definitely much better. The scaling actually looks perfect now. Now let's connect all these lines 9 times to make them again looks like squares. I'm probably gonna end up fixing the wall even more because that doesn't look like natural enough. Now let's delete all these trees and create samples for the rest of the trees. Let's start with 4 samples for an example. We'll leave the first one for 40 and the next one will be 30, the next one will be 25, and then the last one will make it 15. Let's reduce the second one to 20 and the third one to 18. And leave the fourth one to like 15. Now the first tree is a symbol of the tall tree. The second two trees are a symbol of the average tree. Now let's create some symbol of the short tree from that last tree. Put this away from the others. Now let's give it a height of 12. And the next one, we'll give it a height of 10. And they are the small ones. On second thoughts, let's create 2 more trees, smaller ones. Let's give them a height of 8 and 6. I will make the first 3 trees the tall trees. The second 2s are actually the average, and the last 2s are actually the smallest. Now let's spread them to its corresponding locations. Now let's create the trunks, the dead ones. We'll be having an old one, throw it to the ground like that. Now let's create the 2 normal trunks. Let's adjust also its height to something like 12 and 16. I think the other one will look really short. Let's make it 14. Now let's put them aside from our normal trees so we don't get them mixed together. Now let's select our trees one by one and give them some detail. Now I have isolated it, and I will create a cylinder to better simulate our tree. The same height of course, which is 40, and I will fix its location. Now let's fix our sides and our height segments. Let's bump the sides to something like 12, and the height segments to something like 20. We'll convert that to a readable boolean and give it a name, like 40Height3. Now let's delete the bottom face of our cylinder and scale the edge of it. That will allow us to create the roots of the tree. We will connect these edges to give it even more details. Now let's delete some faces to leave some space for our roots. Now let's create a new polygon in here to fix this area. I'm also going to adjust the vertices location around the edges. Now I don't like having triangles in my mesh, so I'm going to create a new edge in here using the cut tool and delete the old edge. Now let's switch to the top view and adjust our vertices even more. Now I'm going to select all the outer root edges and extrude them along the Z-axis. Now let's extrude the edges of the new faces to give our roots some details. I will just jump to the end. 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 That'll be it. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, hit the like button, let me know. And if you wish to see more of my videos, just hit the subscribe button down below. Next episode, we'll be modeling the rest of the trees along with the trunk as well and even more. See you guys next episode.